Hi guys, welcome to a short guide on behavior-driven development. This is a PowerPoint-based animation which describes a scenario, a typical systems development scenario without behavior-driven development, and how we can improve this scenario and deliver the system that is required by the customer by using behavior-driven development. Daryl is a bookstore owner who sells books. He has a bookstore in London. Daryl wants to open up an online bookstore where he can sell books online to customers worldwide. He comes up with this idea, and Daryl meets the business analyst of ABC Software named Jake. Daryl meets Jake and tells him his idea of selling books online. And he tells Jake, "I need an online website to sell my bookstore books." So Jake asked, "Tell me your requirements." Jake asks the requirements from Daryl. So Daryl lists the requirements and say what he wants from the system. Next, after getting the requirements, Jake goes to the project team and starts developing the system, but Jake doesn't get the verification of the requirements that he have understood from Daryl. He just goes with the requirements and say it to the development team. So the development team comprising project managers, developers, QAs and support engineers starts developing the system what Daryl wants. Each interprets the requirements on their own way. There is no uniformity. Upon completion, system is delivered to Daryl. The requirements are not what he expected. The system is not what he expected. Daryl becomes so angry. He has invested all his money, but the system is completely wrong. Jake just asks, "How is the system?" Then Daryl says he has delivered completely wrong system. Daryl feels so disappointed. How can we change this way of developing systems? Let's design and develop a system with behavioral driven development. Let's go where Daryl meets Jake. So Daryl goes and tells his ideas. Jake gets the requirements. Daryl lists the requirements that he wants from the online bookstore. Then Jake goes back and model the system with given when then scenarios, which is called Gherkin language. Jake shows it to Daryl. Daryl goes through it. It's very easy, English-like statements. Daryl understands what is understood by Jake. They come to a common understanding. Jake takes these feature files, these given when then scenarios, to the development team. The team starts developing according to the scenarios. The QA person gets the feature files and gives it to the automation engineers. The QA automation engineers develops automation test cases according to what is needed. The developers develop the system according to the feature files specified by Daryl and Jake. The system is coded according to the requirements. The automation suite is developed according to the requirements. The project manager designs tasks according to the requirements. Everyone is happy, everyone has a common understanding. System is modeled, developed according to the behaviors expected by the customer. Team has uniform understanding. RSpec, JBehave, SpecFlow, Cucumber all helps us to build the system according to the behavior. These tools are plugins which promotes behavior-driven development. System is developed and designed and developed and delivered. Daryl is very happy. Jake asks, how is the system? Daryl is so happy. Daryl says, it's perfect. And he has got 100 customers already registered who have brought books online from Daryl's online store. Daryl's sales increases thanks to Jake, thanks to behavioral driven development. System is developed according to Daryl's requirements. The development team also, they are satisfied. As soon as Jake gives the word that Daryl is happy, Daryl gives more work to the development team, and ABC Software incurs a lot of income. This is how we develop systems with behavior-driven development. Hope this scenario gives you a practical understanding what is behavior-driven development is. Thanks everyone. If you like this video, put a like in LinkedIn. We'll come up with more of these pictorial-based, animated-based scenarios for you all to understand the concepts. Thank you.